This seemingly beautiful forest is actually dead inside. It's what scientists are calling a green desert. But what if we could bring it back to life and turn this into this? We're trying a new and unexpected way of restoring nature that involves killing thousands of trees to revive a river. And whatever these things are.
Trust me, there is method to this madness.
We sent Trishala to Europe's wildest rewilding project, the Muga Valley in Spain, a 100,000 hectares laboratory that's reshaping the rules of nature conservation. Join us on a trip deep into the Pyrenees to see how this transformation actually works and where you might even fall in love with vultures. We're Planet Wild. Welcome to Mission 32.
This is the Muga Valley, high up in the Spanish Pyrenees.
It's a beautiful, seemingly untouched piece of wilderness in the middle of Europe.
But let's test something. What do you hear? Nothing? How about what you see here on the forest floor? Almost no growth.
And honestly, this place is dry as a bone. Generations of charcoal production have left a dysfunctional oak tree forest, which suffocates the ecosystem.
If you look at it, it looks healthy, but in fact it's not. It's under a big stress.
This is Stef van Dongen. Over the past years, he and his organization, Pioneers of Our Time, have been working hard to bring this valley back to life. Many experts believe that this is the most exciting rewilding project in Europe right now. But why? Well, to understand their work, you need to first understand how an ecosystem like the Muga Valley actually works.
You see, there are some key elements that any healthy valley ecosystem needs. Flowing water, sunlight, and biodiversity. And none of those things are present here. Up until the 1970s, this forest had been repeatedly clear-cut for charcoal production. And each time the forest grew back, the oak trees outperformed other plants and it became unusually dense and uniform. Today, there's no more charcoal production, but this unnatural forest remains. And it's not only blocking out the light and suffocating the undergrowth, but it's also sucking up all the water from the ground. That means the water never makes it back into the springs and streams that feed the Muga River. During a recent drought, the basin was pushed into emergency status. 22 towns had to ration their water, and levels in the nearby reservoir dropped so low that it revealed this ancient cannonball factory from the 1700s. This left the river too weak to sustain local farming and the coastal wetlands it should be nourishing. So the well-being of the whole valley and all its inhabitants really depends on the health of this forest ecosystem. And there's one counterintuitive thing that we can do to address all of these issues.
We're gonna cut down some trees.
This might look like deforestation, but actually it is habitat restoration.
By selectively cutting down trees, we are giving the ecosystem room to breathe. This not only allows more light to finally reach the forest floor again, but it literally brings back the Muga River, which in turn can sustain more life all along its route. The work here has already resulted in a 66% decrease in water loss. With all that new light and moisture, an undergrowth can start to form, which is amazing for soil health and creates microhabitats for countless creatures.
Look at this. Literally, the last time this forest floor would have seen sun was like 50 years ago.
And with the funding from the Planet Wild community, we are going to completely transform over 10 additional hectares of the Muga Valley into a future-proof habitat and enable pioneers of our time to conduct a scientific study of the progress here over the next 5 years, measuring everything from carbon capture to water flow to new habitats for wildlife.
Perfecto.
As the valley is becoming habitable again, the iconic animals of the Pyrenees are slowly making a comeback. Otters and crayfish are returning to the river, and even wolves, who were gone for more than 100 years, have now come back. The cool thing is, the returning wildlife is helping us retain this natural ecosystem, as deers and other grazers are eating the young tree saplings, ensuring that the trees don't grow back as thick as before. But there is still something crucial missing.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. Vultures don't really have the best reputation.
You don't say.
But stay with me. You see, vultures are nature's cleanup crew. They have evolved ultra-strong stomach acids up to 100 times more acidic than humans, which can kill nasty diseases like rabies, botulism, and tuberculosis, stopping the spread and protecting other animals from getting infected, including humans. According to a new peer-reviewed study, the unintentional decimation of vultures in India led to the death of about 500,000 people over 5 years. So yeah, I'd say they're really important. Here in the Pyrenees, there used to be 4 different species of vultures. The Eurasian black vulture, the griffon vulture, the bearded vulture, and the now endangered Egyptian vulture. But when Steph got to the valley in 2018, none of them were left.
We have to add the missing link back into the life cycle of the valley, which means bringing back the scavengers.
And we have an interesting way of getting them back.
This is a vulture puppet. We brought 5 of these guys. Trust me, there is method to this madness.
Vultures are social creatures. So if a passing vulture sees these guys, they might stop and settle down and actually nest here. It's like choosing a restaurant. You look for the popular places, right?
This is so crazy, it just might work.
We're installing 5 of these puppets into new artificial nests, and this is only possible because of people just like you.
Good luck, buddy.
Planet Wild is entirely community funded. Every month we go on a mission to bring back endangered species, clean up oceans, or rewild entire landscapes. And the bigger our community grows, the bigger these missions will get. So if you want to support projects like this, consider joining as a backer. There's a QR code here and a link in the description. Of course, a puppet colony alone won't keep vultures here. The valley is still recovering, and for now, there simply isn't enough food.
And vultures pretty much eat one thing, dead animals.
So we are creating a feeding point using leftover meat, just enough to give the birds a head start while the natural food chain recovers.
So the puppet is up, the food is at the feeding station, and now it's the true test. We're just gonna have to wait. Holy moly, this is what we've been waiting for.
So far, a community of griffon vultures have returned to the valley, and that is a huge milestone for Steph and his team. Now, they're hoping for other vulture species to make a comeback, which is why we're also funding this remote-controlled live camera system to keep track of all the birds arriving at the feeding site. And guess what? Just a few weeks later, we managed to capture a video of this beauty. But that's not all.
We've had to stop everything we're doing. Now we're rushing over to the site where we've managed to capture an Egyptian vulture, and now we're gonna tag it. This is such a special moment.
Egyptian vultures are extremely rare, not only in this area. So seeing them return to the Muga Valley really shows us how successful this project already is. To track their comeback, 2 of the new vultures are fitted with lightweight GPS tags, and we'll be tracking their recovery for the next 3 years. If all goes well, these birds will be the last puzzle piece to complete the picture of a thriving ecosystem here in the Muga Valley.
An unhealthy ecosystem, sometimes it's really hard to see what that looks like. And that's why this project is so holistic. It really involves a whole lot of experts and researchers, people who care about the soils, about the chemistry of the area, geology, geography, the climate, all those things coming together to do the best for this ecosystem. And sometimes the best is completely counterintuitive. But I'm standing now in an area where the forest has been taken care of and the river is flowing right here. And it does feel magical. Maybe if I'm lucky, I'll see a vulture overhead.